respect
who doesn't want to touch you with all of that colorful stuff going on?
I even wore my Lego watch for this.
Oh, I love
Give me a break. Look at you.
Manny de la Rosa, NBC Palm Springs, Filipino channel, la 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 la.
Love it.
Congratulations on the film.
Thank you.
I love, love, love. By the end, I was like, oh, it all makes sense.
I know. It's a miracle.
It is good. Right? Movies make sense. It's the best.
It does make sense. It's like a big psychological thing.
It is.
I know. It's crazy.
Right?
Yeah. They try to get
issues.
You inside the head of those kids.
Everyone has issues. That's right.
So it's been 5 years, right, since the first one. How did that distance of time inform what you guys created with this one?
Well, you know, we wanted to have the characters grow up, you know, all the Lego characters, but also, you know, we got to see that the whole thing was taking place in the basement of some humans and this kid who was 8 years old. But now it's 5 years later and he's 13, and the type of stuff that he's into is more mature and more different. He's into the sci-fi and dystopian stuff. And so his half of the story is kind of like a gritty sci-fi movie, and then his younger sister, who's now 8, has got a whole different storyline that she's telling. We had smashed those two stories together into an explosion of craziness.
Well, I'm telling you, it makes sense because you're right. Because he is into Jurassic World.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right?
He's into every Guardians. Chris Pratt movie.
Yes. Exactly. That makes sense. Also, I love that there's a lot more dynamic female characters in this one.
Yes, that's true.
Right?
It's true.
And I love Tiffany Haddish.
Don't we all? She is a force. And a joy.
And you feel her joy on screen. That's such a big part of it.
I think that's what makes her so funny, besides being super clever and hilarious, is that you can feel that she's happy to be there and she's just having a great time. And
right.
So you want to have a great time with her.
Right. And also, it's to me, it's a movie about connecting and building a bridge between generations.
That's
absolutely.
It.
Am I correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah, of course. You know, one of the things, Chris and I both have younger siblings, and my mom always says, you know, your sibling is your greatest ally.
Yeah.
That's the person that you're going to be, you know, going through life with. And you want to protect that.
And you know, and the world is rough out there and people have different points of view, but maybe if we all like stop and listen and reach out with some positivity, we can make the world a better place.
Just listen to the music and let go.
Let your mind go.
Yeah, let your mind go. I love it. By the way, if this whole movie thing doesn't pan out, you guys can do Broadway.
Oh, I love it.
I love it.
All right. Well,
I love it.
I love a challenge. I'd love to do a Broadway show.
And lastly, I love that this evokes the whole, you know, creativity and teamwork and, you know, playtime.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We try to make the movies have good messages, you know?
It is!
It is, like, people are giving you their undivided attention for a couple of hours, and that's very precious, and it's a big responsibility, so we want you to walk out of the movie feeling more optimistic than you did on the way in.
Yeah, but yet it's not, and here's what I love about it, in any of your films, by the way, You don't bat our head with the message.
Right.
You just, I mean, I'm just actually, it's evolving as I walk out of the theater.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah. And that's smart.
It's not a soapbox. We're not giving you a sermon. We want you to have a good time. Above everything else, it's supposed to be fun.
But it needs to be a discovery. You know, like people are going to see what they see in the movie. So you just want to present things and allow folks to write their own story when they watch the movie. Mm-hmm.
Aww. Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. What a fun interview.
Right
there. I'm just trying to protect you.